I think I've lost total respect for you, Dad.
Magic moments when two hearts are kept. Magic moments, memories we've been sharing. I'll never forget the moment we kissed the night of the hayride. The way that we hugged to try to keep warm while taking the sleigh ride. Magic moments, memories we've been sharing. Magic moments filled with love.
Deirdre, I've decided I love the Bold and the Restless. Perhaps even more than I love you.
Oh, you just wait until Marcos abducts Terry's baby. Then you'll be glued to your seat, George.
I've also decided to run for president.
Why, George?
Why the hell not?
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, kids.
How was school?
Don't ask. Hey, Dad, how come you're not at work?
I quit my job, son. What? I've decided to run for president.
Again? Didn't you learn anything from last time?
Oh my God, what a coincidence! I'm gonna run for class president.
Oh, that's great, hon.
How very well timed. This should make for an exciting, fun-packed episode of Political Zaniness.
Mom, he's talking to the camera again.
I know, dear. I know.
Yep, I'm telling you, Candy, this is exactly the way to win the election. I mean, with my mind and, well, your body, this thing's ours.
I don't know, Tommy. I mean, I normally get paid for this sort of stuff.
Yeah, I know, sis. But just trust me, sis, trust me. I mean, let my political savvy guide you to a crushing victory over your opponent, okay? Look, here it comes now.
Hey, Candy. Heard you're running for class president.
She sure is! And she's gonna kick your ass!
Just who are you?
I'm Tommy, her brother cum political advisor. And with my help, we're gonna blow you out of the water.
Yeah, we'll see about that. Good luck to you, Candy. Sweetie, I'd give you a million thousand votes if it was potentially politically possible.
Oh, you're so sweet and strong.
You're finer than a frog's hair. I'll tell you what, why don't you come along in my new Trans Am 350 block for 12-inch speakers and we'll have a good time on the way home.
Okay.
Come on.
George, we've been here for 4 minutes already, and no one's even looked at you. I don't know if you should have listened to Tommy's advice.
You have to be a whore to get by in this harsh political environment. You know that, Deirdre. It takes my gorgeous body to win this thing, and so be it.
Okay, then, Snuckles.
Sir, you're just what I've been looking for.
That's right. A man with strong morals, ideals, and a great ass to boot.
Not exactly, sir. You're a man who clearly has no idea how to run a halfway decent political campaign. And you're just the stool pigeon I've been looking for. Mr. Valentine, my name is Percy Kissinger, and I'd like to be your new political assistant.
Oh, great! That puts me out of a job. See you later, George. I'm going shopping.
You aren't by chance related to Henry Kissinger, are you?
He's my second uncle. Politics runs in my veins. Mr. Valentine, I'm going to make you a star. Maybe even president.
You really think I have a chance?
If you put some clothes on, you just might.
Don't you want to hear my campaign platform?
Mr. Valentine, there'll be plenty of time for that in the interim between this and the next scene. You don't really want to hear all that shit, do you?
Percy, you've got yourself a deal. Congratulations. You're my new political advisor.
Thank you, Mr. Valentine. I won't let you down.
I hope not, Percy. For your sake, I hope not.
We now bring you back to our live coverage of the presidential debate with candidate George Valentine and President George W. Bush.
Ooh, doesn't your father look handsome on TV, kids?
Yeah, but Mom, why are they saying all those bad things about Dad?
What bad things?
Well, they just said he was behind the assassination of JFK. And that he supervised the use of Agent Orange and our own troops in Vietnam? Was he behind a campaign to get kids addicted to smoking? Well, George Bush reckons he has evidence that supports Dad supporting the Germans in World War II.
Whatever, I'm going upstairs to study.
Thomas Valentine, your father is a very honorable man. He's just starting a new world order. So what if the press says he's a megalomaniac?
Yeah.
He's doing it for the people.
Mom? They say he wants to put cameras in everyone's house.
But that's just to stop crime.
Oh.
Tommy, you'll soon learn that it's easier to accept than rebel. So don't make waves, my naive little bunny, and everything will be okay.
Okay.
Now, where did those Secret Service agents go?
Mom, is Dad the Antichrist?
Antichrist? Did you say Antichrist?
Yeah.
Dad straight is the Antichrist, and you're the spawn of Satan! That's for JFK, and that's for Agent Orange! And that's for the 115 stitches I had to endure during your birth!
Holy shit, Mom! You're scaring me!
Okay, so it was only 112. But you just better shut the hell up and face the future, young man! All hail to the mighty reign of the bearer of eternal light!
Mom, have you noticed?
Kiss my ass and amen!
Whoa! Mom, are you okay?
I'm fine, son.
You're good.
Look at your father.
Yeah.
That's my boy.
Kevin Valentine, one last question. What are your policies on economic reform?
Pass.
Candidate Valentine, what are we to do about the growing threat of terrorism?
I'll combine Christmas presents and bombs in one package. That'll show 'em.
And gun control?
Gun control. Guns don't kill people. It's the little children that steal them to kill people.
What's your view on prostitution?
Pass. I gotta go. Take it easy.
George, that was brilliant. You blew Bush right out of the water.
Speaking of blowing things out of the water, did I ever tell you about the time that me and my company ran into a Charlie ambush when we were crossing this river in Da Nang?
No, George, you didn't. This is not the time, okay? Tonight, we celebrate. Mr. President. Huh?
You really think I can win?
Absolutely.
I don't know, Purse. They seem to hate me. I mean, for some strange reason, they seem to think that I sunk the Titanic. I mean, I could have. I was taking a lot of ether back in the 20s. But I would have remembered something like that, right?
George, you're exactly what the people need right now, okay? An everyman hero with a mission.
I'm not sure where I'm following.
It's perfect. Come on.
Mr. President.
Can you stop calling me that?
Well, George, this is it. After months and months of hard work condensed into around about 3 minutes for the viewing audience, this is the day of reckoning.
And in just 1 second, we should have the results of the election. Who will be our next president? Will George W. Bush keep hold of the reins, or will George Valentine steal them away? Stay tuned.
Oh, George! I think somebody is trying to tell you something! One of your political opponents is trying to scare you off in a scary way with some scary scare tactics!
No, this one's for Tommy. I think it's from that Andrew guy.
Who? Oh, you know, Andrew. He was my opponent in the class elections. I think Tommy really pissed him off. That's the third brick this week.
No. Well, how did those elections go anyway?
Lost interest.
Hi, guys. Mom, Dad, I think I'm gonna have to leave town. I'm taking the dog with me. If that Andrew guy calls, I'm not in the country, okay? Yeah, I guess I'll see you guys. Maybe.
Oh, quiet, Tommy! I think they're about to announce the winner of the election!
And the results have just come in. The winner by an absolute landslide is...
Oh, no, you don't! I won't put up with that to be continued crap. I'm gonna know the result of the election. I wanna know it now!
And the winner is George W. Bush by an overwhelming 99% of the national vote. Bad luck for George Valentine ending up on 2%, but we would like to remind you that there is a 2% margin of error. And then again, I guess everything is back to normal.
Everything is back to normal? Why is everything back to normal at the end of every goddamn week? What is going on here? Is this just a television show? Are we all just goddamn characters in a television show?
Dad,
no. Seriously. Is my whole life fake? Is this all a facade? Am I just the figment of someone's imagination?
Don't be ridiculous, George!
I don't know, Randy.
When two
hearts Everything okay, George?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Come here and have a snuggle before
I'll never
you go and talk to
the way that we hugged.
Congratulations!
Well, thank
you're
you.
My new political advisor.
Well, thank you, sir.
Go on, fuck off out of here.
Memories we've been sharing.